Hi everyone, today we are going to see about Spring Boot Security Google OAuth 2 sign-in. In this demo, I am going to show you how to add the Google sign-in in your web page. First, create a project in your Google Cloud platform. So now here I am creating a new project in Google Cloud platform. The project name I am giving Google Service. So I click the create button. Project is creating now. Okay, look at here in the notifications action bar, you can see the status of the project creation. This task is in progress. So still the Google service project is creating in your Google Cloud platform. So in the meantime, we can create a Gradle project from this chart.spring.io website. Here I am giving a group ID com.talktoamreswaran.projects and then artifact name I am giving Google service. We will add the dependency later. So I click the generate project button and then I extracted the project into my machine. Just copy this path. Import the Gradle project into your Eclipse. Use import option. Gradle, existing Gradle project option to import the project into your Eclipse. Provide the project root directory and then click next, next and finish. Google service Gradle project will import into your Eclipse. So it's taking some time to import into the Eclipse. Okay, in the meantime, we can go to the Google Cloud platform. We can see the project is created or not. I think the project is created. This is the dashboard of your project. Okay, click finish here. Okay, now the Gradle project is imported successfully into your Eclipse. And then this is the Google Cloud platform. Go to the APIs and services, and then we need to enable some APIs and services to use the Google Cloud credentials into your website. We need to enable the Gmail API. So in the API library, search the Gmail API and click enable button. So Gmail API service will enable to your project. It's enabling now. Okay, now the Gmail API is enabled. Next, we need to enable the Google Analytics. Search Analytics. Okay, this is the Analytics API. So enable the Analytics API service into your project. So these are the default APIs we need to enable to add the Google authentication in your web page. And then you need to enable the Google Plus. So scroll down and then you can find the Google Plus API. Okay, click here and then click enable. Google Plus API will enabling now to your project. So enabling API. Okay, Google Plus API is also enabled in your project. Now go to the credentials and then create a credentials. Click create credentials button. Choose OAuth client ID. To create a OAuth client ID, you must first set the product name on the consent screen. So go to the consent screen, provide the email address and then provide the product name. So product name I am giving Google service, and then this is the home page URL, product logo URL. These are the fields are optional. So I am trying to saving, but it's showing some error. Product name shows to users field. We detect a problem. Okay, because the project name and then the product name should not be the same, and it should not have that name sequence. For example, the my project name is Google Service and the product name is Google Service, it will not allow. So this is a, so that's why it's not allowing. Now I'm changing the product name now. So look at here, I am trying to create the product name with the term Google Service, but it's not allowing. So we should make the appropriate product name while creating a credentials. So I am giving the product name as My GCP App. So now I click the Save button. Now we can create the credentials. Choose the web application and then provide the web application name, My GCP App, web app I am giving. And then the authorized JavaScript origin, everything I am going to try out in the my localhost. So I am giving the URL http://localhost:8080. I'm just zooming my web browser to make it better visible. So in the authorized JavaScript origin, we need to provide the URL, the localhost URL. So where you are running your application, it should work. So you have to add that. And then for the authorized redirect URI, so we need to add this http://localhost:8080 login. So authorized redirect URI, we need to add this and then click create button. So your client ID credentials are created. So this is your client ID and this is your client secret. Just copy the client ID and client secret and paste it into the one of your notepad. So make sure your client secret should not be shared to anyone. Okay. Now in the Google platform side, everything is done. Now we need to add the client ID and the client secret in your Spring Boot application. Go to the build.gradle file and add the dependency Spring Security OAuth 2 and then Spring Boot Starter Web and then Spring Boot Starter Test. Spring Boot Starter Test is a test compile. So Spring Boot Starter Web for writing a REST API, Spring Security OAuth 2 for enabling the OAuth for your project. Now refresh the Gradle project. So Spring Security and then Spring Starter Web, all the dependencies will download. So go to the main class file, Google Service application. So we need to add, before that we need to add some security OAuth client credentials in your application.property. So here look at security.oauth2.client.clientid. For this property we need to provide the client ID. So whatever we generated in the Google platform, we need to provide a client ID. And then for the client secret, we need to provide in this application.property. This is access token URI, authorization URI, token name, authentication scheme, and then user info. Everything we need to provide. And then the scope should be in profile and email. So this is the application properties. We need to make a change. Now under the source and main resource directory, I am creating a folder called static to keep the HTML pages in this folder. In the under the static folder, I am going to create a HTML file. The HTML file name I am giving index.html. Okay, HTML file is created. Here in this, it is a simple HTML file. Now I am going to add a simple link. So click here to Google login. It will redirect to the user API. So this is a simple index HTML. It doesn't have any fancy menus and then the buttons and everything. It's simple. In the Google service application, the main class file, I am adding that REST controller annotation to write a REST API of the user, the user API. So in the request mapping, I am giving the URI value as a user. By default it's a get method, so I did not provide any request method type. And then this user method should return the principal object. So here I am returning a principal object. So this is the request mapping method, I mean API method. This method will return the principal object whoever calling this user API. So it will return the principal object. The principal object will store the Google authentication details when you are running the application. I will explain that while running the application. Now I am going to create a new class file called web security configuration. This is the main class file to enable the OAuth. So it should be extend the class web security configure adapter. I think I'm searching in interfaces. It is should be a class. Yeah, web security configurer adapter. So you need to extend the web security configurer adapter. For this class file, you need to add the at configuration annotation. And then in this class file, you have to enable the at enable OAuth 2SO. So this is the annotation we need to enable the OAuth between the Google and to your website, I mean to your web application. And then we need to add the override method for the web security configuration class file. This is the HTTP security. By default I am disabling the CRF, and then the ANT matches, the index.html does not require any permission. So by using the ANT matcher, I ignore that permission. I mean, I'm giving all the permissions to permit all any request should be an authenticator. So I refresh the project. Now I'm going to take a build of this project by using the Gradle clean build. Go to the command prompt and then take a build by using the command Gradle clean build. It will take a build now. For taking a build, it will take few minutes to build your application because it will run all the Gradle tasks like compile Java, clean, find classes, and then it will try to run the test cases also. Right now we don't have any test cases. Okay, now the build is successful. Now go to the build and libs directory, run the jar file by using the command java-jar. So application is started now. Okay, look at here the console log. Tomcat is started on the port 8080. This is the path we given in the authorized URI in your Google Cloud console window. Now go to the web browser, hit the URL. Before that I will remove all my Gmail account from the browser. Already I logged out all the Google My account, so I just removing the account. Okay, just removing. Amareswaran Vela, this is my personal email ID. Now we don't have any Google sign in my web browser. I'm just zooming the browser. Now I'm hitting the URL localhost:8080. It will redirect to the index.html. In the index.html I added the login. It will redirect to the user. Before that we need to enable the sign in of the Google. So look at here, we have to log in into the Google account, sign in to continue to my GCP app. So provide the Gmail ID and then the password. Now it will redirect to the user's API. The user's API, we return the principal object. So this is the principal object we received from the Google. So authority role_user, and then look at here the details object, the ID, email, and then verified email as true, name talk to Amareswaran, and the given name talk to, the family name Amareswaran. This is the picture URL, and then locally is in English. So this is the principal object we have received from the Google after the signing. These are the details, session ID and token value. Now if you copy this URL and paste it into the browser directly, it will login into the, without login the Gmail account, it will return the result now. Okay, look at here. So now I am logging into the Gmail. It will directly redirect because the Gmail account is already logged into the web browser. Okay, now I am just hitting the same URL, the user. It will return the principal object we received from the Google. Okay, so these are the principal object we received from the Google details and then token value everything. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel to get more video alerts. Thank you.